I don't talk a lot about my personal things. Many people can tell that I'm really quiet. When I just know in people, I don't talk a lot. I just like quiet and quiet and quiet. And when I'm getting confidence, and I'm getting to talk more. And I really changed. Going out of your country or where you live, it helps you to understand another point of view. It helps to know what other people is thinking and not just to like put a limit to your what you're doing. You know, in Oaxaca, it's everything a mess there, and I don't like it these days. And it was a beautiful city. This is one of the pictures of the downtown. This is another church. This is the beach. This is one part of the market. It's just desperating for people who is there because it's affecting everyone, mainly public schools, because public schools are not having classes now. Many people is complaining about this because the government doesn't do like much to solve the problem. And now the city doesn't look like it was before. It's like dirty. It's just like kind of destroyed. In Mexico, when you're driving, maybe there's a stoplight and some people just go. And if there's no police or something, they just don't obey. And here you have to stop. They stop even there are no cars around. And I was like, there are no cars, why should they go? And it's like, okay. Yeah, I miss food. I was thinking about avocados, and here I can get one for $1. And at home I get like three or four for $1. So I was like, yeah, it's really expensive. And what I don't really like here is beef. I don't eat beef in the cafeteria. And the rice, it doesn't have flavor.
Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town.
So I was with a Japanese friend, Chicago, and Chicago, we got a map, but it didn't have like this rose of the winds. And I was looking at the sun, and I told my friend, I think that's the east because the sun comes from the east. She was like, no, this is the north. You're not okay. And I said, no, but the sun is going that way. And she was like, yeah, I know. In Mexico, it's like that? And I go, yeah, how's it in Japan? And he was like, I don't know. Imagine this is the earth and this is the sun. Mexico is here and Japan is here. How it goes. And she was like.
Well, I learned to swim like 3 years ago, more or less. It's really good because it makes me to feel relaxed when after like a really busy day or stress day, and I go to swim, I just get relaxed and I sleep very well just to be ready for the next day. Like, I remember once I was talking in Spanish and I was like, why don't you answer me? And he was, are you talking to me? And yeah, why don't you answer me? You're talking in Spanish. And it was like, oh yeah, okay, I know you're talking in Spanish. It was really funny.
Bueno, en México es un poco distinto, pero está bien.
A pastel con frutas y la torta con chocolate.
So, the first time I got into the lab, I was kind of nervous because it was my first experience teaching Spanish. And the first meeting with the instructor, they were telling us that we had to speak in Spanish, the whole class, the whole lab. And I was, okay, that's gonna be easy. I began to to speak Spanish, but they didn't understand me. And I was like, no, this is difficult. The class just turned funny, real funny, and they were like, Spanish lab is really funny. Because they're trying to speak Spanish, they say like sometimes wrong things and funny things.
What do you say slower?
Lento, más lento.
Más despacio.
Más despacio.
Okay.
Oh, más despacio.
Más despacio.
I'm laughing, we're not laughing at them, but what they're saying. And sometimes I think they're laughing at me too.
Ella es una estrella de la ciudad.
You always learn from everything you live.
Cool, bye.